unleash hell!
Again, his return to oWoFan19, Chris Southerns.
Hey, everybody.
How's your arm feeling?
It's doing a lot better now. I have about 10 days till I get my cast off.
That's good. That's good to hear. Well, now tonight is episode 29, and what's the special event tonight?
WrestleMania 29.
Yeah, it's WrestleMania night, so we're going to give you our thoughts who are going to win for tonight. Now, I still think this is a travesty right here. The pre-show for the Intercontinental Championship belt, which is going to be aired on YouTube instead of on the pay-per-view. What's your thoughts on that, Chris?
I think the Intercontinental Championship match should be on the pay-per-view. It's kind of like WWE just showing the Intercontinental Champion that title doesn't matter to it. To the WWE, in my opinion.
That's horrible. I think it's stupid. I really do think it's stupid that they're... Like... Someone calling you or something?
No, it's Texas. Sorry about that.
Yeah, and also, we were talking about the Intercontinental Championship. Also, earlier, we were just talking about the United States Championship belt. Yeah. That's not even on the card.
Yeah, it's even worse what they're doing with that one, showing Antonio Cesaro that they just pretty much gave him the belt and they don't care about it.
That's just stupid. I mean, Antonio Cesaro, like you said, he's a good wrestler. Just needs to practice on the mic skills for a little bit. But not him not having a match... I think it's stupid.
Yeah, I don't know what WWE's doing there. They're just showing that the USA title means even less than the Intercontinental Championship title.
It's stupid. Okay, what about the Fandango versus Chris Jericho?
Shouldn't have been a WrestleMania event. That's pretty much all I have to say about that. It's Fandango. Or, Fandango tickets or whatever you want to call them. As I call them, I'm just going to, for the sake of the show, I'm going to call them movie tickets. So movie tickets, he's new. I don't think he should even be allowed to be on WrestleMania. He hasn't even been there a year yet. And I mean, I understand that Chris Jericho is going to be wrestling him, but that doesn't mean that he should be on WrestleMania.
Yeah.
It's not worthy. I mean... He's not even that great at wrestling from the moves I've seen him do.
Well, let me ask you something. What happens if this match turns out to be really good?
I don't know. I'd be really surprised, but I still think it's more of like a Raw quality match instead of pay-per-view for his first match. I guess it would be his first match.
It is his first match. Yeah. His actual first match. Because of all the matches he could have had on SmackDown or Raw... He's not doing it if they say his name right.
Yeah.
Which is kind of stupid. It's called Fandango. A ticket. Ticket website to order tickets.
Should ask him if I can pre-order some Lords of Salem tickets or something.
But if it turns out to be a good match, I would apologize to Johnny Curtis, which is his real name. His real name is Johnny Curtis. He won NXT 2 years ago.
Huh.
And we haven't seen him since. And now he comes back as Fandango or Fandingleberry. And he comes out with this dancer, that girl dancer, which is really hot. Now, okay, change the subject. They're talking about WrestleMania classic moments right now. We're watching the pay-per-view. But what's sad is they're talking about WrestleMania 20. And you know what's sad about this one? They're not going to show the Benoit match. As they show Triple H, but they're not going to show Benoit or anything like that on here. All right, Susie. You know that's not right, you know.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Gross.
But, okay, after the Fandango-Chris Jericho match, the eight-person tag team match.
I don't know what to think of this one. I mean, I think that the it's more of a raw quality match as well.
I think it should have been on the pre-show instead of being on a title belt.
Yeah. That is, it's definitely not, it's pre-show quality, yeah, I would say. Because pre-show is almost pretty much just like, hey, you know, it's a small raw event or something. Or
yeah.
Something. But it, I don't, I mean, there was definitely enough hype backed behind it, but it's just, I mean, the Bella Twins, they just came back. And the Funkadactyls just started wrestling. If you would have just left it as, you know, Cody Rhodes, or the Rhodes Scholars and Tons of Funk, I think is what they're called.
Yeah, they're called Tons of Funk.
If you would have just left it as those four, it probably would have been a really good WrestleMania event. I mean, I'm sure it's going to be a good match, but it's just, I think it's more better quality with that.
I think I'll be going to the bathroom and taking a dump probably after that match.
Yeah, just eat a lot of hot sauce or something.
And hot sauce doesn't agree with me.
Exactly, yeah.
But I would still probably order JR's barbecue sauce. I heard that stuff's really good. Okay, moving on. What about the Triple H versus Brock Lesnar match?
I think now that Triple H has had time to rehab his arm, I think he has a good shot at this one. And if he brings out that sledgehammer, I think it's all over for Brock. I know he could take probably a couple shots, but once we've seen Triple H in his deadly sledgehammer shots.
Well, look, I just thought of something, and I've been hearing about this. No one's thought about it, but I just read about it. What happens if Shawn Michaels turns his back on Triple H tonight and causes him to lose?
I couldn't see that happening just because, you know,
Shawn Michaels has done it in the past before.
Yeah, but this is Brock Lesnar. We're talking about somebody who, you know, snapped Shawn Michaels' arm. I don't think he would turn his back for Brock.
I mean, I know that. I can't see that either, but I just started hearing about it. But who knows? But to me personally, you want Triple H to win, right? I want him to lose.
You don't want to see it? Well, I mean, I don't expect to see him after... Well, maybe he might be on Raw after WrestleMania, but...
Sorry about that. That's my parents, by the way.
But I could see him on WrestleMania... Or, sorry. The Raw after WrestleMania, if he wins, I could see him on there, but I don't expect him to start wrestling again.
That's the whole point. I mean, look, if he wins, his career's still on, but we won't see him probably until SummerSlam.
Yeah. I just don't expect him to be doing much.
So he's going to be like a part-time player.
Yeah, kind of like Undertaker.
Rock, Lesnar.
Yeah. But Undertaker's career's always kind of been like that. He just comes and goes.
Well, actually, Taker, I can understand why. He's better than all of them.
Yeah, and he's been a legend since he started, so.
Yeah, so I can't. I don't blame Taker. The other guys, I can't.
Speaking of Taker.
Yeah. Who do you go for? Taker versus Punk. How do you think that match is gonna turn out?
I'm just gonna go with. I think he has 100% win ratio there, so I think it's a good idea to go with him. I don't think CM Punk will be the first one to finally beat him at WrestleMania.
I'm actually rooting for Punk to win this one. I really am. I've been a CM Punk supporter. I've been arguing with people on Facebook about Punk and Taker, and I kept saying that he's gonna win. Taker's gonna lose.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I mean you could.
I'd be surprised. I mean, stranger things have happened at WrestleMania.
That's true. But let me say this. Let's say if Punk does win, where does he go from there? He's always been bragging about things. Like, he's done a lot of great things. If he beats Taker, he's got something to brag.
Well, he's going to brag a lot. And I guess after you beat Taker at WrestleMania, you probably deserve a title shot for some title. I mean, I don't really want to see him hold the WWE title again for a while, so maybe, like, give him the heavyweight title.
That would be a good idea.
Don't give him a bottom round title unless you're, you know, trying to bring it back, like the Intercontinental or US title. If you give him one of those, you better be pushing him.
Yeah, better.
So that title comes back to prestigious again.
Yeah. But let me also ask you this. I thought about asking stuff like this, but I just decided not to. If Taker beats Punk this year, which I really hope he doesn't, and if he does, you think that rivalry between Taker and Punk will keep going on?
I would love to see another Hell in a Cell match between those two.
Yeah.
So I would be all for that, and maybe even throw a title in there, because that just puts an extra, you know, icing on the cake for a rivalry when you had a title.
That's true. I agree with you with that one.
I think it could be a good rivalry and would definitely help the WWE get out of this PG hole they're in.
PG sucks. I mean, I know they're going back to the 80s and all that kind of stuff, but still, it's stupid.
Yeah.
Look, back then, there was still blood. And now they're trying to get rid of blood.
If we don't see blood on this pay-per-view, I'm going to be very sad.
Same here.
Especially with the No-Holds Barred match. Between those two crazy people.
There better be blood in that match. If it's just only for one match, it better be on that one.
Yeah, I could deal with that. It's a match with no rules, so.
Okay, the six-man tag team match. The Shield versus Randy Orton, Sheamus, and The Big Show.
I gotta say, of course I don't want him to win, but I'm pretty sure The Shield's gonna win this one.
And they're talking, I agree with you, I want the Shield to win. I believe in those guys. But there's been talking that Randy Orton is supposed to turn on Sheamus and Big Show. And he's the leader of the Shield, or a member of them. What do you think of that idea? Because there has been talk that Randy Orton's supposed to turn heel this year.
I think it could work. That would definitely be probably about the only thing I can imagine that would turn him heel. Especially, you know, since people really like Sheamus. Nobody cares if he turns on Big Show, but
because Big Show's already a bad guy. And he's teaming up with these guys, so if he turns his back on him, it's not even going to be special.
Yeah, but if Randy Orton turns his back on those guys, he'll definitely be heel again. And I don't know, I think it would bring an extra awesomeness to the match. Because I think the Shield's going to win, I just don't know how they're going to do it. And I think they need a little help with Big Show being there.
Yeah. Okay. Twice in a lifetime, Rock versus Cena.
I've been saying this, and I'll say it again. I'm pretty sure that Cena's gonna get the title just because Rock's got a whole bunch of movies he signed up for.
He's scheduled to be in next month's pay-per-view.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think he might lose, and then, of course, he's got to get his rematch.
But let me ask you this, and there has been talk about this, too. John Cena turning heel.
I don't know. I mean, it would definitely bring, if he turned heel in the Rock match, it would bring an extra, that match to a whole new level. And, again, you know, if he's scheduled for next month's pay-per-view, it would be a rematch, and then, you know, we wouldn't see him for
SummerSlam again. Or next year's WrestleMania?
Yeah, because like I said, he's got a bunch of movies he's got to do. It tears down on someone's body doing all that at once.
Yep.
I know he likes the wrestling, but maybe he should come back.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Movies. Rock is a sellout. He's a sellout.
Well, I mean, I guess a lot of people think that, but he always said he wanted to do what his dreams were, and he's fulfilled all of them.
Yeah, but have you realized that a couple of times people chanted, "You sold out"?
Yeah, I realized it. I don't agree with it, because he didn't really sell out. He's just doing what he loves.
That's true.
He actually likes doing the movies. Especially the Fast and Furious ones, because...
Those are good movies. Those are good movies.
He's really big on doing stunts, so...
But let me ask you something. This has also been talked about, the S.H.I.E.L.D. thing. John Cena is supposed to be the leader of the S.H.I.E.L.D.
I would probably like the S.H.I.E.L.D. after that. I don't, if Cena turns heel, I can see it, because he's been, heel once?
Only when he pretty much started, and after that, people started cheering him. After that, people started booing, and they've been booing him since.
Yeah... After the whole Rock thing. The first Rock.
Yeah.
He's been booed a lot.
Well, that's our thoughts about the WrestleMania. The pay-per-view is getting ready to start, so ladies and gentlemen, we'll be seeing you.
Hey. Yeah, that's Sheamus. This is the...
Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Paul right here. That is Kyle right over there. And this is Wingman. Yeah, you got one wing broken.
AK Chris.
He's supposed to turn heel, I think, I found out.
So you think he'll get old Dune song back? I missed that one.
No, he hates that song, dude.
I love that song.
And lucky guy right here. That guy's huge, he scares me.
I think he's
next world champion right there, Dean Ambrose. ZCW, that's how he got noticed.
I just say that Roman Reigns is the only one that would be afraid to meet publicly.
Yeah.
Do you remember when Mr. Kennedy used to do those off the top rope? But I think, yeah, he's gonna do it.
Can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look way down the river, and what do you think I see? I see a band of angels, and they're coming after me. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my
I know, he would be.
Whoa, look, he's actually doing it!
Oh, it's so good. It's great.
Yeah, that was right. Hit it with the earth! Hit it with the earth!
You can't be taking it like that. Just like,
no,
told you punk wouldn't end it. You're getting text messages.
There ain't no break.
Either that or it's all Facebook stuff.
Mostly Facebook.
Oh, that's great. Can hold my body down. When I hear the trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground.
So well, now he's going to be wrestling at WrestleMania 30, probably.
Body down.
At the end of WrestleMania 29 and also episode 29, what did you guys think?
I thought every match but the Taker match was gay.
What was yours?
I liked the tag team match, title match, and the Undertaker Punk match. Other than that, I'd give the rest of the pay-per-view like a 2. Out of 10.
Why the fuck is Cena still a face?
Yeah.
Why is he champion? Why does Brock suck?
I was expecting a heel turn. Once again, like last year, the Rock versus Cena match was the worst match I've ever seen on that pay-per-view. That was the horriblest pay-per-view match I've ever seen.
That was like freaking ECW failing quality. WWE ECW quality match.
Which, by the way, I'm holding.
Yeah, that match would be a match that would kill an independent company.
The company would be dead the next day.
Yeah.
But that Rock versus Cena match, horrible. Just completely horrible.
I hate to say it, the Undertaker and Cena should have been the main event. Undertaker and Punk. It was my main event.
Same here.
I mean, the Brock Lesnar and Triple H match, that was even bad.
Yeah. That actually was pretty good, though.
It got really shitty there in the end.
I mean, it was good in the beginning. It was good in the, you know, how it started. But then it just turned out.
It's like, how many pedigrees, how many F5s, how many times locks does the steel chairs have to be a prop, you know?
Like, yeah, it was like, you could tell, like, what?
There was enough finesse.
It should have ended 10 minutes before it ended.
Granted, it's an old bar, but there should have been more finesse wrestling.
And blood,
yeah.
I mean, it's UFC versus WWE. King of Kings, yet there was no bloodshed. There's no, like, real pain.
I mean, yeah, you saw blood coming out the guy's mouth, but that still doesn't count as
We saw more blood on an actual Raw episode between those two. You know, just by cutting them open, you know, hitting on the pole and stuff, you know?
But yeah. What did you guys think of the rest of the matches on the...
There should have been a Diva Battle Royale for the championship.
I agree.
I just thought the whole pay-per-view was pretty lame. Like I said, but 2 out of 10 again, in my opinion.
The Punk versus Taker match, that was the main event. That was still the show.
Yeah, and I tell you the truth, if you told me Royal Rumble and WrestleMania, Royal Rumble. That was way better than this one.
Yeah, because Punk and Rock had a better match.
Yeah.
The twice in a lifetime match, horrible. Just completely horrible. Do not do a third in a lifetime match. Do not do a third one.
There
please.
Shouldn't be. No,
no more Rock versus Cena matches.
Yeah.
No, I'm afraid now, based on the performance of The Rock lately, of a Lesnar and Rock match. I'm afraid of that, because...
It just doesn't make any
sense. He's turned into a pretty boy. He's like, I don't want to hurt too much. Let's just keep the fundamentals.
Well, it doesn't make any sense how he does two really good matches with Punk and then on the main stage fails to...
Again. Fails again.
Yeah, fails to live up to his what he can really do.
So, Rock, if you watch this, I'm glad you're watching. You do not deserve to be in wrestling anymore.
You should leave unless you're going to come back full-time.
And be a better wrestler.
And not
be... And actually, I'll make us pay $70 the pay-per-view to watch you wrestle.
Yeah, because that twice-in-a-lifetime match, once
why,
again...
Why won't... Hey, Rocks, why won't you do something for your fans and make us not pay to watch you wrestle?
Yeah.
Unless basic cable is kind of just paying, yes.
Yeah, you should stay on basic cable. No more pay-per-views.
Yeah. Just for once.
He can come back if he stops doing movies, because then he could take a bump and not worry about it.
Yeah, instead of earning his good looks. Yeah. Well, that's the episode, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John.
That's all I think of the WWE.
But here's a good idea for you, WWE.
No, that was
so good. We're gonna go try out for y'all tomorrow and make a real show.
I have a broken arm and I could wrestle better than that.
Yeah, I'm not a trained wrestler.
You get out of the Kimura lock easily. You wouldn't feel a thing.
Well, and also, let me ask you guys a question. I said this to you earlier, but does that championship belt when Cena was holding it, did it look like a small belt?
Yeah, and in my opinion, it doesn't fit the WWE. I mean, I thought the belt would grow on me. So far, it hasn't.
It looks more of a TNA belt than it does WWE belt.
I don't know. I like TNA.
I mean, I think he's gonna make it relevant again. Would put more effort into having it, be worth more.
Yeah.
Like more diamonds, more jewels. I mean.
True.
I don't know. I feel like the
belts. Those are nice.
Those were good belts.
I feel like the more jewels they add, the cornier the belts.
I mean, also
they look
you got
plasticky and.
This
belt kind of looks a lot better than the WWE belt a little bit.
I would rather have that any day, even though I hate the ECW the WWE did. I don't know, I think they're making the belts look really cheesy with all the
jewelry.
Another rant of mine is, since Brock Lesnar's been back, he's now 1-2.
Yeah, he lost 2 matches and he's won 1 match.
Yeah, so... But he's not putting anyone over, really. He's just, like, losing to legends and shit. It's not...
I don't count John Cena as a legend yet. I just call him an icon.
Okay.
He's not that level yet.
Future Hall of Famer.
Yeah, future Hall of Famer.
But Brock Lesnar is a future Hall of Famer.
True.
But when's he going to get his due, though? I mean, we keep him as...
Not for a while. They get along.
Talking about something like this. I would like to see. We were both.
But you pay him all that money for a slap in the face, so you're only signing you to lose.
I think we both agree that Brock Lesnar should get a push. So should Jericho instead of losing all the time or pushing people.
I think we could see some good matches if Jericho stops wrestling these bottom rung superstars.
Yeah. Fandango. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed this episode. I hope you did.
More than you enjoyed WrestleMania, because that wasn't worth $60.
And we got $80 to see us.
Yeah, we're free. That sounds
well. Bad. Not well, for not me, Josh. Me and me. I'm
oh,
not
shut up, dude.
That's all you get for free. No,
that's it. What's the bathroom for free? Bam.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have a good night. My name is Joshua James.
Chris.
Paul.
And we hope you have a good day.
Woo woo woo!
We know it. There we go.
Apparently he doesn't.
Look at all that. Give him an arm for that.
I'll just sit here and go,
God, I wouldn't want to do that.
No, I'd be licking deodorant off of my armpit.
You know what? I even touched it.
Oh! Oh, God.
I'm over here sweating.
One of these days the sky's gonna break and everything will escape. And I'll know. One of these days the mountains are gonna fall.
Finally, this is episode 29, but also this is, it's WrestleMania 29.
That's the way the ironing pad is just soaked.
Thanks for the extra, Susie. We're recording what you said was on there.
Take care. Bye.
Okay.
He's killed it.
Okay, one more time.
Okay. Take care. Spike your head.